it's working. Now, 2 years ago, we started a movie project in Karlsruhe, which had the very important target to put zombies into Blender. As you can see on the screen, Mike is necessary, or can I just be
recording?
Just for recording. Sorry. Sorry. I'm.
Hello.
No, I think I can't. I just use this one. It's okay. For two years ago, we started a movie project in Karlsruhe, which had the very important target of putting zombies into Blender. As you can see at the picture, this involves a lot of screen, poorly lit, and with a lot of damages in the background, a hardworking scientist in foreground, and several zombies in the background. Not to mention the wide-angle lens, which is also quite necessary for such a task. We had a very interesting story, virtual background, which the story had this crazy idea that this, that the room will get smaller and the actors will grow, and it was really, really big effort. It was 19,000 effect frames we had to process with 1.5 person and not much time. Well, we worked it out. This involved developing a new key, a new solution. We tried all the solutions on the market, right there on the open source market, to be exact, and nothing worked really out. Even the current keying solutions in Blender don't really work. I can show you why there's a problem and how we solved it. The main point is there are certain parts of a green screen which are pretty easy to be done and some don't. I just show it right here. The interesting part is the hair part, and the really interesting part is the hair part where the green screen has defects. So we just managed to get it done. You can see the hair parts are pretty nice. You can see the transparent areas. Everything is fine and dandy. Normally you get a rather big checklist what you have to do right. I don't mention all the details. The very important point is we fucked them all up. But we handled it efficiently. How you can see down there, this is a picture where you can even see a really, really bad problem when the actor is walking out of the green screen. It's rather funny. So we built the Blender über Keyer. We built it from scratch. We followed the image keyer, image-based keyer, you know, probably from Nuke. We automated it, everything with cores, reflection mats, and whatnot, and made the whole solution a lot more automatic. In 1 minute, how it works. You maybe know how difference keyer works. It uses a maximum. We use some average subtracting. We roughly cut out the actors, rebuild the background, using an impending node, which is new to Blender, scale the mail, build core mate automatically, tweak the automatic, and so on. And very important, if you've got actors on the run, use a Luma keyer, which also works in the process, and denoise the material, or you'll get problems with the shadows. The very basic idea is built with this picture from Tears of Steel. You can see on the left side the cutout background, how it's worked out, and on the right you see it's just a one-click solution works. So, to composite the whole thing, we did something really crazy. We use cycles as a compositor, which works really great. If you get use this keying process, you get a diffuse mat, which can work in cycles. If you use billboards, frames, and use them as emission planes. And you can get pictures like this out of it. If you want to render all this, 10 minutes per frame is obviously necessary. You have to use some other project. We used Boink and distributed it to several machines out there on the internet. We used 10 of them and a generic render script to pull all the dependencies and did all the dance and put it back. Fun fact, you can do it with pretty cheap cards. It's rather affordable, and well, 64-bit is quite a speed boost. If you have any questions, please ask.
We have 15 seconds for questions. Is the product free?
Yes.